Mark, you give yourself to Yejun to be her husband, to love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others to be faithful to her so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Yejun, do you give yourself to Mark to be his wife, to love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others to be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Wonderful. So I, Mark James King,
I, Mark James King,
take you, Yejun Miao,
take you, Yejun Miao,
to be my wife,
to be my wife,
to have and to hold from this day forward,
to have and to hold from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish for the rest of our lives,
to love and to cherish for the rest of our lives,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law,
this is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Thank you. And will you repeat after me? I, Yejun Miao, take you.
I, Yejun Miao, take you.
Mark James King.
Mark James King.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn law. Wow.
Blessed are you, God of steadfast love, source of our joy and end of our hope. Bless this ring, given and received, that it may be a symbol of the vow and covenant Mark and Maria have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So Mark, please take the ring, put it on Yejun's finger, and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you as my wife.
I honor you as my wife.
Let's pray together. Blessed are you, God of divine patience. Help the unbroken circle of this ring to symbolize the never-ending forgiveness and care that Mark and Maria have found in you, and that you will help them show to each other. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Yejun, take this ring, please. Place it on Mark's finger. And repeat after me. I give you this ring.
Mark, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I have, I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you as my husband.
I honor you as my husband.
Lord God Almighty, thank you for the love that Maria and Mark obviously have for each other. Thank you for the love of these friends and family who have gathered around them here today. Thank you, Lord God, for these rings which symbolize your covenant and commitment with us through Christ, and which symbolize the completeness of the union that Mark and Maria will enjoy. Thank you, Lord God, for your blessing on their lives. Thank you for the blessing of family, of friends, of the blessing, Heavenly Father, of employment. The blessing, Lord God, of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose presence is here, and we pray whose spirit would abide with Mark and Maria today and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.
Actually, so we're going to go there first. And then the witnesses.
So Mark and Maria have joined themselves to each other by solemn vows, signified here today by the joining of hands, the giving and receiving of rings. And so by the authority as a minister of the gospel and by the laws of the province of Ontario, I declare you to be husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Mark, you may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Mark and Yejun King. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Until sometime later. This was a couple of years ago, I believe it was Christmas Eve, and we're in Walkerton. I was drinking beer in a garage with a bunch of guys. It was a cold, snowy night. Mark and Maria were in town, and they came over. And you know, I knew Maria was a girl for Mark then, because any woman with the tolerance to put up with a cold garage and a bunch of guys drinking beer for as long as she did that night, she's got the tolerance it takes to live with Mark.
Finally, another woman to put Mark in his place. I love Maria. She always speaks her mind, and I feel very close to her. The first time meeting, our girls loved her. She's great with children, and funny, and affectionate, smart, and genuine. Just a beautiful person inside and out. I felt close to her immediately. I know she loves Mark dearly. I can see it in her eyes, and she loves him when she speaks of him.
We've met Miss Tanya Wilhelm. This is Mark's sister, Sandy King. I'd like to introduce... Sorry, please, go ahead. Another bridesmaid is Loretta Liu. And the maid of honor, Miss Emily Frazier. And I'm going to assume everybody knows who these two here are. I don't think we need to introduce them at this point. And on the groomsman side, we have Mr. Larry Fast on the end. Mr. Kevin Frazier right beside him. And the best man, Mr. Paul Wally Wilhelm.
Yes, and welcome Maria to her family, and hope everybody's having a good time. And everybody, I know everybody's made quite a sacrifice to get here in this weather, and we've got people from as far away as Ottawa, maybe even farther. So that's it.
Happy all of you made it in this weather. Because when I got up this morning, I just said, Mark, you had to get married on a day like this. So anyway, I hope you all have a good time and you get all home safely.
And I'd also like to say, don't be drinking and driving. You spill too much.
And another thing she always says is, things go in threes. They have three kids. When we grew up, they were always going on about getting married, and for about 4 decades, they never thought it would happen. And when I was 39, Rick and I had little Thomas, and it was quite a surprise to us. But he has turned out to be the greatest gift I've ever had, and I love him to death. And thank you so much, Rick. And when David was 39, he and Amy had Lila, and she was an equally wonderful gift to the family. And now Mark, how old are you?
39.
Another example. So I would like to propose a toast to our future nephew, Brayden, and welcome him to the world, to Brayden.
Hi everyone, I'm Loretta. This is going to be short and sweet because I'm actually really bad at this. But thank you for everybody that made it here and during the blizzard. Thank you, you two, for having me joining the party. You guys look great. Congratulations on the baby boy and toast, and everybody.
Thank you. Today is actually a beautiful day. And it's going to be remembered forever. I'm just going to tell a little short story. How I met Kevin is actually through my good friend Cindy over there and Mark's cousin, Jeff. Mark's cousin, Jeff, introduced me to Kevin, and I think at one point, Mark was looking at Jeff saying, "How come you didn't introduce Emily to me?" So from at that point, I felt I actually owe Mark something, so I've been looking for a girlfriend for him forever. Until I met Maria, I thought she was the perfect girl for him. And you guys went through a lot for the last 2 to 3 years, right? And I'm really happy for you guys to be here today. And I really...
Kendrick wants to say something too.
Yes.
He doesn't like your speech.
I wish you guys happy life, happy, healthy, and long life together. Let's propose a toast to Mark and Maria.
Cheers.
What part of that?
He held the glass.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'd also like to ask everybody to join me in a round of applause for the wonderful work the bridesmaids have done.
Oh, I won't forget my buddy.
Today was quite well.
Today went quite well, I think so. I think our wedding party did a great job. All of them contributed and helped us a lot. Wally, Steve, Kevin, Larry, Tanya, Sandy, Loretta, Emily, and also Cindy's father, Mr. Lee. Thank you very much. All of you helped us make today happen, and we really appreciate. Can we please give them a one more clap? Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I want to make a toast to everybody here. For all of our beloved ones, to our marriage, to love, I want us and all of us to raise up our glasses. Okay, I cannot drink alcohol, so. Okay. Cheers.
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 Our mothers gave the love we needed when we needed it. Both of us are so grateful that the love from both of our mothers and the rest of our families. I would like to thank the bridesmaids for the wonderful work and great help that they did. I'd like to propose a toast and appreciation for how beautiful they are and all the things that they've done to make today beautiful. So thank you.
Cheers.
Finally, I would like to thank the groomsmen and my best friend, my best man, Wally. Wally and I have been best friends since we were in elementary school together. More than just friends, more like brothers. There's a lot we have learned together. His four daughters are like nieces to me. Tanya only wishes I could have taught him how to have a boy. But it doesn't mean you're any less of a man, Wally. Don't let anyone tell you that. I want to give special thanks to the people who really went an extra mile and helped me with their special day. My mother, my sister Sandy, Tanya, and a friend Mike Morrison, who also couldn't be here today. I'm going to hand things over to my best man, Wally. Keep in mind, he has a horrible memory, likes to exaggerate, he even forgets where he is sometimes. Please just humor him and pretend you believe what he has to say.
I didn't even think you existed. If someone could have told me that Mark was going to get married, I'd be like, yeah, whatever, right? Not going to happen. So I knew that when he found you, Maria, that you must have been pretty special. So I know you mean a ton to Mark, and I'm happy for both of you. And I'm glad you're in his life, and I'm glad he's in yours. He's a great guy, and he's my best bud. And we've been through a ton together, and we'll continue to do that. And now you're along the trip, so be prepared for slowness. Lots of drinking, because that happens. And
why does everyone keep saying
that? and patience. but ultimately a lot of fun and a great time and lots of happiness. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So anyways, one of my favorite memories with my brother was actually one winter. If you, anybody that's not here that doesn't know what that house looked like, it had two roofs. There was a very high one that was really steep, and then it dropped like that, and then it went like that and further. And when you shoveled the roof off on the second one, it would make a big snowbank. And I think my father knows where the story's going there. My brother and I got the idea one day to take a toboggan all the way up to the top roof and see how far we could get. Now, this was pretty dangerous because when you get further down, there's also hydro wires down by the other end that go through, but we figured that we could get underneath those through the second roof. So we got all the way up the top roof and we came down real fast, and then we took a jump, and then there was a big bang. And then we went down further and flew down the snowbank, down the yard, and almost right clean near to the end of the yard. And two of us, just the adrenaline rush and holding on and ducking under the wire. And we got to the end and we were just a laughing, and this was great. All of a sudden we find out somebody comes smashing through the back door. He's got his vest on, and he's my father. He ended up coming home a little early that day. He's in his wool socks, still from Packers, the freezer, no boots on, flying out the door like this, and he's looking up here, and then he sees us, and of course, our first instinct is, how are we going to lie our way out of this one? And there you see the toboggan trail going down one road, on the other, down the yard, and there's Mark and I at the very end, sitting there all smiling. So we didn't find out until years later. My father told us he was actually laughing about it inside to himself afterwards, but didn't want us to know at the time. So that actually is one of my favorite memories of something I did with my brother. So that's my stories.
Celebrate good times.
Do you remember what it is?
Yeah.
Don't forget it, whatever you do, because if you forget it, it's not fun. That's what that is.
Yeah.
Can I see it for a sec?
Yeah.
I'm gonna try and peek and see again. Yeah. I peeked. I'm just kidding. No, it doesn't matter if I know what it is. I'm gonna get you, sir. You have the marker still. Can you sign? You chose the three of spades.
Yeah.
Can you take that? Can you sign the back of the three of spades? Just on the back there is fine. Hold up, we have a little table. Wonderful. Good. Sorry, you know what? If I'm an idiot, bam, 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 bam. Yeah, so about that card trick. You know what? I'm sorry about that. Oh, I'll tell you what. The end of the trick, because everyone's waiting for the third coin, the end of the trick comes at the end of the phrase. Time is?
Money.
Money. What time is it, sir?
Quarter to 11.
Okay, and just slowly, if you can just move the time out of the way for a second.
Oh my god.
Oh my god! How did you do that?
I'm sorry, it got stuck. It's a special moment for you today. It's a very special moment. And what I'd like you to see is, yeah, it's something a little bit weird. Yeah. Good. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Come together.
Right. Same card.
Yeah.
That in two different
I'll give you that. I'm a little confused.